See, errors ka theory, explanation is done. All the formula needed I have given. We'll solve few numericals, but before that, let me complete significant figures and मतलब दो और छोटे छोटे टॉपिक्स हैं उनको भी खत्म करके I'll start. So topic is significant figures. Significant figures.
तो
सिग्निफिकेंट फिगर्स, सिग्निफिकेंट फिगर्स किसको बोलते हैं? सी सिग्निफिकेंट फिगर्स का रोल एक्चुअली मेजरमेंट में है. इफ आई टॉक ऑफ मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ 12 एंड 12.0 और 12.00, तो इन मैग्नीट्यूड ऑल ऑफ देम आर सेम, राइट? सबका मतलब 12 ही है. इफ आई से व्हाट इज मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ द थ्री नंबर्स, सो ऑल द थ्री represents the same way. As a number, they all are same. But if I say 12 meter, 12.0 meter and 12.00 meter, then they have different significance. Then they are different. So, as a measurement, they are different. As a measurement, they are different. So, what is different in them? This measurement is done by a device or an instrument which measures up to nearest meter. This measurement was taken by an instrument which measures up to nearest meter, and this measurement was 12 meters. So this is used, measures up to nearest meter. Right. What about this one? This is taken using a device which measures up to nearest decimeter, and this one is using centimeter. The claim of the first measurement is that measurement will have an error of plus minus one. The error, maximum permissible error in it is one. So if someone claims the length is 12 meter, that means he says it will be 12 meter. It is 12 meter with a permissible error of 1 meter. So 12 plus minus 1. If someone claims that measurement is 12.0, actually he means to say measurement is 12.0 with a permissible error of 0.1 meter. So the second measurement has permissible error of 0.1 meter. Clear? Then third one, 12.00 meter. What is that? 12.00 plus minus 0.01 meter. So maximum permissible error in this is 0.01 meter. Clear? Hello?
Okay.
So this is the difference between them. Now, how do we explain them? So we talk in terms of significant figures. We say there are two figures, two digits in this VR, which are significant. Only one of the digits is uncertain, this one. And rest of the digits are certain. So one uncertain digit along with all certain digits are known as significant figures. Here, this is uncertain digit. And these two are certain. So this has three significant figures. This has only two significant figures. Here this digit is uncertain. Rest of the digits are certain. So there are four significant figures in this measure. Clear? Eh? Now, question is, how do I read number of digits, significant figures in a measurement? So rule is, there are a few rules. First rule. All non-zeros are significant. All non-zeros are significant. Right. Then all digits between two significant figures is significant. And repeat, all digits between two significant figures is significant. Third, all zeros preceding first non zero digit are insignificant. सबसे पहले नॉन जीरो डिजिट के पहले जो जीरो लिख दिया आपने वो सब सिग्निफिकेंट नहीं, दे ऑल आर इनसिग्निफिकेंट, राइट? देन ऑल जीरोज सक्सीडिंग लास्ट नॉन जीरो डिजिट without decimal is not there. Decimal has not come here, but zeros are there succeeding last non-zero digit, so they are insignificant. Without decimal are insignificant, right? They are also not significant. So which zeros are significant? Now this is important. Zeros after last non-zero digit and after decimal, ये दोनों चीज हो चुके, decimal भी आ चुका है और ये are significant. So zeros after last non-zero digit and after decimal are significant. So, ये पांच पॉइंट्स हैं जो आपने याद रखे टू डिसाइड हाउ मेनी सिग्निफिकेंट फिगर्स आर देयर इन द मेजरमेंट एंड सिग्निफिकेंट फिगर्स हैव समथिंग टू डू विद लीस्ट काउंट ऑफ द मेजरिंग इंस्ट्रूमेंट, राइट? वो लीस्ट काउंट को ही बताता है एक्चुअली. इफ आई सेड 12.00 मीटर्स देन इट मेजर्स अप टू नियरेस्ट सेंटीमीटर. इफ इट इज 12.00 आर मेजरिंग यूजिंग an instrument which has least count of 1 millimeter, something like that. Okay, so let us take some examples and see how many significant figures are there in this. 1.315, 0.013, 1.315. Tell me, how many significant figures are in this? 1.315. Sorry? Four significant figures. In this one, again four significant figures. Here, again four significant figures. Why? These two zeros are insignificant. This is not significant, this is not. Because any zero which is before first non-zero digit is not significant, right? But these are significant. Why? They occur after last non-zero digit with decimal already used, right? So decimal has already been used and the two zeros trail the last non-zero digit, hence they are significant. So there are four significant figures in this. Again, this and this, four. In this one, there are only three. 1350. Decimal is not used. Decimal has not come yet. So, decimal is not there. Hence, there are only three significant figures in it. Clear? Hai?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, this is concept of significant figures and how do we count significant figures, right? There's a small logic also behind why these zeros are not counted, are not significant, because they say due to change in system of units, number of significant figures should not change, right? So if somebody has made a measurement 135 meter, so how many significant figures are there? Three. other person will claim that it is 1350 decimeter. The same measurement different people will say are different, right? 135 meter is 1350 decimeter, is same as 13,500 centimeter, is same as 1,35,000 millimeter. But number of significant figures should not change. Why? Because they all represent the same measurement, but you are trying to express them in different system of units. So system of units change kar dena se measurement nahi change honi chahiye, right? Number of significant figures nahi change honi chahiye. Clear? Hello. Okay. So ye kahani, yes. So ye kahani hai aapke significant figures ki. Now, significant figures in calculation. Calculation mein significant figures kaise use hote hain? Calculations with due respect to significant figures. Significant figures. Right. So, first one, multiplication and division. Multiplication and division. During multiplication and division, what you have to do is your final answer should have same number of significant figures as our minimum among all the operands. For example, there is length measured as 12.0 meter and there is a width measured as 1.25 meter, right? And somebody says measure the area of this rectangle, right? Measure the area of this rectangle. So area of this rectangle would be what? Length into width. Multiply them. 0, 0, 25, 125, 150. So answer is 15.000. 12.0 into 1.25 is 15.000. Right? Now, what should I write? Shall I write it as 15.000? Sorry? I'll write it zero. As correct. 15.0. Why? Here there are three significant figures. So your final answer should have minimum of the two. Minimum of the two is three only. So I'll say only 15.0. Right? Clear? Okay. Then in multiplication and division, as I said, there should be same number of significant figures as our minimum among all operands. Right? Now, what about addition and subtraction? In addition and subtraction, you don't have to look for significant figures. Instead, you have to look for number of places after decimal. So final answer should contain same number of places after decimal as our minimum among all operands. If I ask you to find L plus B in this case, so what will be answer? 12.0 plus 1.25. So answer is 5, 2, 3, 1. So it is 13.25, but that is wrong. Here there is only one place after decimal. Here there are two places, so you have to round it off to one decimal place. So my answer will be 13.2. So the sum is 13.2 centimeters. So 13.2 centimeters answer. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I'll give you 2-3 calculations. Do it. calculate AB AC square AB plus BC AC plus BC. So these three calculations you have to do. I'll give you 3 minutes. In middle of solve karo normal calculations and for uske baad express karo answer ko. So what is the answer for AB? AB A को B से मल्टीप्लाई 3.28409 है. So 3 significant 3.28 is the answer. Meter square. Now AC square. So AC square is what? 1.53 into 8.0 into 8.0. 97.92. So what should my answer?
97.98
meter cube. Two significant figures होने चाहिए आपके answer में. You cannot have more than two significant figures. So 97, you have to round it off to two significant figures. यहाँ पे round off करना. तो 97.92 है तो उसको 98 meter cube लिखो. Right?
Yes sir.
Now AC plus BC. AC plus BC. से
29.5
सॉरी
29.5
तो नहीं आना चाहिए. क्यों आया आंसर हो सकता है नहीं आया
29.46
पॉसिबल ही नहीं. एसी कितना आया? एसी इज एसी तो बताओ. एसी इज 12.24 आ रहा है विच इज एक्चुअली 12. नहीं एसी इज 12.24 एक्चुअली इट इज 12. राइट 12.24 आ रहा है. लिसन टू दिस. In fact, to be precise, 12.240 आ रहा है. 0, 8, 3s are 24, 4, 2, 8, 5s are 40, 42, 2, 8, 8 plus 4, 12. ठीक है? But मुझे round off करना पड़ेगा कहाँ पे? दो significant figures में. ये हो गया 12. Now calculate BC. BC is how much?
15.29.
नहीं ना बता. You'll have only two significant figures. BC. C may we have two figures, B may we have four, so their product will have exactly two. So 8 threes are 24. Ah, 8.0. You know, we are 153. AC plus BC is 29.
नीचे दिख नहीं रहा, ऊपर लिख देता हूँ.
AC is 12, BC is 17, AC plus BC is 29. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
AC plus BC is 29. Right? Hello. अच्छा, लेट अस ट्राई टू डू इट अदर वे. ए प्लस बी इंटू सी करके देखता हूँ. लेट अस ट्राई टू डू इट अदर वे. ए प्लस बी इंटू सी, देखते सेम आंसर आता है कि नहीं आता. तो फर्स्ट यू हैव टू डू ए प्लस बी. परफॉर्म ए प्लस बी, इन दोनों को ऐड करके तो आएगा. डू इट. That's all in significant figures which you have to remember. Now, next is order of magnitude. Order of magnitude. So what is order of magnitude? Sometimes we are not interested in precision. Instead, we are interested in understanding how close the given measurement is to power of 10, integral power of 10. For example, if I write 317 grams. So this is closest to which power of 10? Integral power you have to check. So 10 raised to 0 is 1. 10 raised to 1, 10 raised to 2, 10 raised to 3, 10 raised to 4, 10 raised to 5, 10 raised to minus 1, 10 raised to minus 2, 10 raised to minus 3, 10 raised to minus 1. So sometimes we are not interested in exact measurement, precise measurement. Instead, we are interested in understanding, knowing only approx value, close to which power of 10. So 317 is closest to which power of 10? Is it close to 1? No. Is it close to 10?
10 to the power.
100. So it is closest to 100. So I'll say order of magnitude is 10 raised to 2. So order of magnitude of 317 gram is 10 raised to 2. Is it clear? Height of Mount Everest, 8,848 meter. So what is order of magnitude in meters? This is close to what power of 10?
10 raised to closest power 4.
To. This is closest to 10 raised to power 4. So this is closest to 10,000. Right? Lies between 1,000 and 10,000. It's closest to 10,000. So I'll say its order of magnitude is 10 raised to 4. Clear? Got na? Order of magnitude, बड़ा सिंपल सा चीज है. मास ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन इज 9.1 इंटू 10 रेस टू माइनस 31 के जी. व्हाट्स ऑर्डर ऑफ मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ मास ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन?
हेलो
10^-32
कैसे 10^-31 इज क्लोजेस्ट टू 10^-31 ओनली 9.1 इज क्लोजेस्ट टू व्हाट 10^-1 तो 10^-1 इनटू 10^-31 दैट इज 10^-30 के ओके
यस
सो 10^-1 इनटू 10^-31 दैट इज 10^-30 केजी ले नाउ दैट्स योर ऑर्डर ऑफ मैग्नीट्यूड दैट्स end of major part of the chapter now we'll discuss some numericals on errors and error analysis and then small points are there I'll read out those points and then chapter is over so let me start with numericals so let's start with simple question time period of simple pendulum as measured using stopwatch with least count of 0.1 second if it makes Twenty oscillations in .0 seconds. Length of pendulum. Is measured as .0 meter. Calculate value of G with permissible error using formula T is equal to 2 by root L by G. Use pi is equal to 3.14. Chha. Try karo. Kai baar questions pucha hoga different examples mein. Obviously in different words, but pucha kai baar hai. Batao to kya aayega. I'll give you 2 minutes. Try karo. Then I'll solve on board.
Sir, T is equal to 2 pi
root L by G.
ये कुछ फॉर्मूला है
हाँ, ये फॉर्मूला है हमारा सिलेबस में सेकंड लास्ट चैप्टर एसएचएम में आएगा बट आपको अभी बता दिया मैंने टाइम पीरियड आप सोच लो लेंथ आपको बता दिया है सोचने के लिए जी की वैल्यू आपको दे निकालनी है पाई का वैल्यू आपको दे दिया रिमेंबर पाई एक नंबर है इसमें एरर मत अप्लाई कर देना आप पाई इज 3.14 दैट मींस आई एम अज्यूमिंग दैट पाई इज एक्यूरेट ये मेजरमेंट नहीं है मेरी ये दे रखा आपको गॉट द आंसर मिला किसी को
सर 0.0247
नहीं डियर आना तो 9.8 के आसपास ही था कुछ तो गलती कर दी आपने जी इज व्हाट 4π² L/T² राइट सो 4 3.14 का स्क्वायर लेंथ इज 1.00 अपॉन टी स्क्वायर टाइम पीरियड इज 40/22 2 का स्क्वायर इज 4 4 गेट्स कैंसिल सो 3.14 का स्क्वायर
So 314 into 314 you have to do. 314 fours are 1256. 314 9 334 942 to 985. So 9.8596. Now you have to round it off to how many digits? Three significant figures and three significant. So three significant figures. So this is 9.86 meter per second square. That's the answer. But that is not important part. Important part is to find permissible error. Find permissible error. Important is to find permissible error. वो कैसे निकालोगे? अच्छा, इसमें कोई कंफ्यूजन है? हेलो
सर, टाइम को डायरेक्ट 40 सेकंड्स क्यों नहीं लिया? 20 से
दैट इज ऑफ 20 ऑसिलेशंस ना, दैट इज नॉट टाइम पीरियड.
अच्छा, मतलब
मेक्स 20 ऑसिलेशंस इन 40 सेकंड्स. एक ऑसिलेशन का टाइम पीरियड. डन. आया किसी को? Hint is, try to find percentage error in measurement of G. G के measurement में percentage error निकालने की कोशिश करो. बाकी actual error निकालने जाओगे तो it won't be possible for you. बहुत complicated error. क्या रिलेशनशिप? टाइम पीरियड सर, जी इज प्रोपोर्शनल. ये तो कांस्टेंट है, इनका तो छोड़ दो. एल रेस टू वन और टी का स्क्वायर. तो परसेंटेज एरर इन जी इज परसेंटेज एरर इन एल प्लस टू टाइम्स परसेंटेज एरर इन टी. अब निकाल लो. बताओ भाई, परसेंटेज एरर किस में? एल में कितना है? व्हाट इज परसेंटेज एरर इन लेंथ? परसेंटेज एरर इन लेंथ कितना है? लेंथ कितना मेजर किया आपने? व्हाट इज मेजर ऑफ लेंथ? 1.00 मीटर. तो 1.00 मीटर में एरर कितना है? 0.01 अपॉन 1.00 इनटू 100. राइट. सो कितना हो गया? 1%. किसमें? लेंथ में. टाइम पीरियड में कितना एरर है? व्हाट इज एरर इन मेजरमेंट ऑफ टाइम?
सर टाइम में एरर 0.01 सेकंड.
0.1 अपॉन 40 इनटू 100. 40 हो गया तो कितना होगा? 10/40, 1/4, 1/2, तो 0.5. सो जी में है परसेंटेज एरर 1.5. तो 1.5% एरर है किसके मेजरमेंट में? जी के मेजरमेंट में. बट जी का मेजरमेंट कितना है?
What is measurement of G?
9.86.
G का 9.86. तो 9.86 का जरा 1% निकाल लो, तो 9.86 सॉरी 1.5% निकालो, सो डेल्टा जी आ जाएगा इतना. तो कितना हो गया 0.15 meter per second. Therefore, G का वैल्यू इज 9.86 0.15 meter per second. Is it clear? Hello.
Yes. Yes, sir.
समझाना. तो कभी कभी डेल्टा जी निकालना पॉसिबल नहीं होगा. सबसे डिफिकल्ट वाले सम्स ऐसे वाले होते हैं. डेल्टा जी निकालना पॉसिबल नहीं होता. आप परसेंटेज एरर इन जी निकाल पाओगे. तो यू कैलकुलेट परसेंटेज एरर इन जी, राइट? वंस यू नो परसेंटेज एरर इन जी, कैलकुलेट दैट परसेंट ऑफ द वैल्यू ऑफ जी. तो वैल्यू ऑफ जी ऑलरेडी निकाल के रखी आपने, तो परसेंटेज एरर निकाल. परसेंटेज एरर 1.5 है, तो उसका 1.5% निकाल लो. ओके, समझाना. चलो आई विल स्टॉप हियर. कल ये चैप्टर भी करेंगे हम लोग एक्स्ट्रा क्लास का, और थोड़ा सा एटॉमिक स्ट्रक्चर भी करेंगे. सो बी प्रिपेयर्ड. दो लेक्चर होंगे कल. चलो आई विल स्टॉप हियर ना.